Hello Gundam fans, this is Brian92, and today I'll be looking at the 144 high grade of Zaku II, which came with the PlayStation Vita Gundam Breaker bundle. I already reviewed the RX-72 that came with it, which basically was a recolor with a more pastel color look. So was the Zaku II, but this one is made to look like the RX-72. And they did a fairly good job. But there's one major problem, and it's in the waist area, because, as we know, a Zaku II, the torso and the skirt armor is all one color, usually a dark green or a dark red, and they didn't want to do any changes there, so they gave you stickers for everything, all the way around. Because without that, it'd just be the blue all over. I do like the fact that they give you a little bit of detailing, so it does kind of look like the RX-72. But the problem is, once you get close up, you can see the folds it has to do. There's cuts here so it can fold around the rounded parts of the skirts. Here it's starting to bunch up and peel. And this part here, it covers over where the panel flips down for the bazooka to hold. That's not going to last if I do it any more than a few times. So I really wish they had done something different, but I understand why they didn't want to. But when you're paying more money for a limited edition set, you expect a little bit more, and unfortunately they didn't deliver here. They did give a yellow mono eye, which is accurate to the RX-72 eyes, and the Gundam Breaker logo I put on here is the black one. You can use a white one, but there's very little area that's not white. So I just went with the black. You have two of those. So if you want to give another one to the RX-72, you can. And besides that, the Zaku II, the old one, has always been pretty sturdy. I never really had a problem with anything falling off. The hosing on the legs is loose enough for the articulation, but it doesn't come out. It is a solid kit. I really don't like the stickers. But I knew that going in, so I can't really complain that much. And now the head is ball jointed, but you don't get a whole lot up and down. You can rotate it. And the eyes are pretty much, the model is pretty much stationary. It doesn't have any kind of a piece you can move with, apart from like ripping the head apart. The arms can hinge forward at the torso, and they'll rotate. The shoulder spike can hinge out. The shield is ball jointed, so you can get them all the way up to the side. Rotation below the shoulder, one joint at the elbow, ball jointed wrist, nothing at the waist. They hadn't figured that out. The front skirts can move together. Side skirts can move. You see they're already starting to come apart with the sticker. Legs can get that far forward. Back some, out a little. Double jointed knee, but that is basically what you're gonna get. And that's not because the hoses, it's just how it is. Now the ankles, I've mentioned this with other reviews of the Zaku II, but they are so good for what the rest of the model has, because they're double jointed in here, they got a hinge up here, and then they have a hinge with a polycap, and then they have a ball joint foot, but there's also some hinging in there. So check that out. You can get a really weird chicken walker Zaku if you want. Like that, you can get some good outward poses, and if you have the right angle, it won't look weird. But the fact that the ankles are doing all the work, and the knees are really limited, and the hips are really limited, you can pull off a few or more poses than the Gundam, I would say. But it's still nothing amazing, for sure. So we have the familiar Heat Hawk, which is in the lighter gray, like the backpack and the joints. And it is the older one, which has a very thin handle, so it's very loose in the hand. You can get it into a sweet spot sometimes, but usually it'll fall through the hand or just wibble around. And you do have the hole for it. but be careful of the sticker. And it does fit rather nicely once you get it in there. Just have to kind of raise it up a bit and then slide it down. And it's pretty snug. And we have the machine gun with a trigger finger hand, movable scope, movable handle. It is wibbly here, but the thing is, because of the stock, it kind of helps. You can move it out of the way, and it won't look weird. And we have the bazooka with the other trigger finger hand. Yeah, left and right trigger finger hands. We don't get a lot of those because us lefties are abominations. So, movable scope, movable extra handle, and the fact that you can use this. I'm going to try not to wreck the sticker. Unfortunately, there's no torso joint, so I can't get it out of the way. But okay, it's not coming down. It does fit. It just doesn't fit as well as the clip for the ARC-72, but it will rest in between where the handle is right here. And it, as long as you don't, like, bump it, it should be fine. But the one thing I've always liked about the original Zaku II is the fact that it comes with the leg-mounted missile pods, which the missiles are individual. You can pull them out if you want to do some kind of diorama and firing out. Now, I've got them separate, so I can actually put them on the leg. Now, I always get worried about flexing these because, I mean, you know, it's plastic, so I usually take off the whole thing and then try to do it at the thinnest part of the leg and then get it around. Now, even once you get it connected, it's a little loose. It's not super secure. So the best area is actually getting the right end piece on. That would help. That'd be helpful. But the best area is right at the bottom. It seems to be the sweet spot, but it doesn't take much to move it. So I really like the leg-mounted missiles. But like I said, it's very easy to get them jostled, and then they start moving all over the place, and all they're on the other side now, they're in front. But I do like them. So the accessories are actually really good. It has quite a lot, and they do fit everywhere. Like, they have the only thing that doesn't have a place to store is the machine gun. But everything else is good. So we'll start with, I don't have any of the original Zaku II high grades on the shelf anymore. They've been boxed up for years. I don't know where they are. So we'll start with why I recently built the original high grade Zaku I, which I think is a decent comparison. And then we'll take the original one and compare it to the brand new Zaku II Shark Color, which is so good. And I forgot to put it in my top 10 of 2020. I really should have, because it's so good. And then finally, I'll compare it with the ARC-72 that I came with. Then you can see what they were going with the whole color swap, and how they would have nailed it if it wasn't for that pesky skirt armor. Let me bring the Zaku and the ARC-72 together. The two-pack is good to have. I really like this combination. Now, if you can find it at a good price, unless you only want the models and not the Vita in the game, maybe someone is selling it separately, I don't know. But I wouldn't go crazy, because they are older kits. You can buy the normal versions for very cheap, like probably $10 each before shipping. So unless you really are interested in the colors and the whole Zaku II Gundam thing, and if you want to get the Vita, which is what I want to do, I just figured get the whole thing at once. So that is the reason I got it. There, it's a unique thing to have. So that's about it, and I'll see you in the next review.